Good evening. He's the NRL's biggest name, Latrell Mitchell, out celebrating the birthday of close mate Raiders star Jack Wighton. By the end of the night, the pair was behind bars, charged over a brawl with each other. The NRL Integrity Unit is investigating whether the players take part in the upcoming All-Stars match is now in doubt.
Early this morning, league's biggest name, Latrell Mitchell, out on the town with mate and Raiders star Jack Wighton. They were celebrating Wighton's 30th birthday at the Walsh's Hotel in Queanbeyan. Nine News understands the pair later tried to enter Canberra's fiction nightclub but were refused. Later, they were skylarking, shoving and pushing one another near the club. Police were called, both were arrested and locked up overnight. Wighton has been charged with fighting in a public place and failing to move on. Mitchell has been hit with three charges: fighting in a public place, a fray, and resisting arrest. Clearly not a great way for either player to start the year. However, was it as bad as it sounds? An NRL player who witnessed the incident and has declined to be named has told Nine's Wide World of Sports that police overreacted. The player said the incident between Latrell and Jack was nothing. They were just mates who had a bit to drink, mucking around. But then cops came from everywhere. About four of them jumped on Latrell and forced him to the ground and twisted his arms behind his back. He wasn't resisting and was screaming at them to stop hurting him. Whatever the take, for Wighton, it follows another wild night out on his 25th birthday when he assaulted several men and later praised the club for their support.
They've all stuck by me in the end, you know. They've also given me the hard word that anything ever happens again, you know, I'm basically at the door.
Both men are key players in the Indigenous All-Stars, set to play in New Zealand this week. Mitchell and Wighton missed a publicity shoot for the event today. It's unclear if both will make the trip. Mark Burrows, Nine News.